Today on Turner Classic Movies, our birthday tribute to Cary Grant is all the rage. First, Grant finally gives in when he can no longer avoid girlfriend Betsy Drake's machinations and every girl should be married. Then Sergeant Grant's vacation is turned into a rescue and recovery mission during a South American crisis. And Deborah Carr wants nothing to do with Grant's designs to make her a homemaker in Dream Wife. Turner Classic Movies places in the home today.
He's like a walking encyclopedia. He knows every picture, who was in it, who the character actors were, who the director was, who the producer, even the cameraman. It's just incredible. He's got that type of brain.
I think he really knows more about movies, old ones and new ones, than anybody I know.
He's loaded with talent because a lot of people look up to him, like him, and respect, which is a great word. They respect Robert Osborne.
Robert Osborne. His unique insights are just one more difference between classic movies and Turner Classic Movies.
He really does know more about my movies than I do. It's amazing.
Grace Kelly.
Spencer Tracy.
Vincent Minnelli.
Typical Hollywood story.
Damn good actors.
I might become a writer and want to do a story about it someday.
A writer?
Maybe.
What made me write the subject was roses.
Me too.
A couple of things. One thing is that my parents died, which allowed me the freedom to really talk about what went on in our household.
What didn't it strike you as peculiar?
Everything strikes me as peculiar.
There's something you're not telling me.
Well, we all have our little secrets.
I don't think I would have dared my father's wrath. As the Irish say, he would have given me a thump on the lug if I had done it.
Yeah,
answer me.
And then the other was, there comes an optimum moment when you get a certain distance from your real experience, where you're free enough to be true to the material and still exercise your imagination. And I had reached just that point.
When I left this house 3 years ago, I blamed him for everything that was wrong here. When I came back, I blamed you. Now I suspect no one's to blame. Not even me.
Family relationships get a little prickly. In The Subject Was Roses, Saturday night at midnight Eastern, here on Turner Classic Movies.
Spanning two oceans, three continents, 5 years in preparation, 2 years of production.
The Evangel, sir, 2 points off the starboard bow. K.O.K.
Now, James Michener's monumental novel, his beautiful, fierce vision of paradise, comes to life. From the broad sweep of its epic drama, to its most intimate emotions.
Such a deep and tender nature, so profoundly affectionate that I dare not mention them.
But you have dared. And in doing so, you have dishonored me.
Oh, 2 years now, I've thought of nothing but you, night and day, on sea and land, nothing but you. And I'm not going to let you go a second time.
Andy, don't! Stop, Reaper! Reaper, I'm expecting, I'm a child!
my sister, Noelani.
Do you realize that your father expects you to marry this girl and have children by her?
Yes, I will explain this to her later.
Now, make it clear now.
Tonight on Turner Classic Movies, we hop the pond to peek inside MGM's British studios. First, Robert Taylor stars in Sir Walter Scott's classic tale of Ivanhoe. Then Queen Ava Gardner finds a gallant Robert Taylor the most attractive of all the Knights of the Round Table. And dandy Stuart Granger relies on the kindness and assistance of friends to rise from rags to riches in Beau Brummel. Turner Classic Movies is moving up in the world tonight.
A special encore presentation. Digitally remastered. Never before seen footage.
Well, that's all right, Mama. That's all right with you. That's all right, Mama. Do it any way you do. That's all right. Yeah, that's all right. That's all right.
That's the Way It Is Special Edition. A special encore presentation. Sunday at 10 p.m. Plus 19 more Elvis movies Monday nights in January.
Well, that's all right,
no, rock star.
Anyway.
Movie star. Star of the month. Only on Turner Classic Movies.
Thank you. Thank you very much.
Get lost down the old King's Road, through a maze of twisted tongues. Streets slick with corruption and paved with heartache. This is where even angels fear to tread. A boulevard of bad intentions cast in fog where the only light burns from midnight kisses and someone's private rage on a public stage. From innocent faces with a price to pay. Behind the gates of the MGM British Studios, Thursdays and Fridays all this month. City built from lost wages. Signs burn red and blue temptation. In a showroom frenzy, footlights strobe off a jumpsuit wrapped tight around a dream come true. A man in his element, on and off the stage. A candid portrait of the king of rock and roll and our star of the month, Elvis. That's the Way It Is Special Edition. A TCM World Broadcast Premiere documentary. Monday, January 15th at 8 p.m. Plus 19 other Elvis movies. Monday nights in January. When the sky falls off the edge, there are men who speak with their guns and laugh in the face of a town called Nowhere. Fight is right, and wrong is a song like the ballad of an outlaw on the run in the films of Director of the Month, John Sturges. Wednesdays at 8 p.m. Get lost this month on Turner Classic Movies.
Come one, come all, we're gonna have a ball. Just leave.
leave your cares and woes and let your troubles fall. You'll find a starry sky behind that cloud you're under. It's such a perfect time for one real wonder.
Hi, I'm Robert Osborne, and welcome. We're awfully glad you're here with us. Now, for our theme of the month, we're looking at films made by MGM in Great Britain, either at a studio for hire or at the studio facilities that MGM purchased in England after World War II, the Elstree Studio outside of London. And that's where our next several films were made. These next films also have something else in common. They all have to do with the very British concept of knights and chivalry. Our first film is Ivanhoe from 1952, starring Robert Taylor and Elizabeth Taylor, joined by Joan Fontaine, George Sanders, and Emlyn Williams. Now, there was a time when any boy who loved red-blooded adventure stories could tell you that Ivanhoe was the hero of a popular book by Sir Walter Scott about a dashing knight in the era of King Richard and the Crusaders, when men always seemed to be crossing a moat or climbing a castle wall or fighting with an axe and sword to either save or serve a young maiden. At least that's how it always happened in the movies. Well, that era has rarely been put on the screen with more vitality, color, or dash than in our next film. And to put this movie Ivanhoe in its proper time frame, it was made just after Robert Taylor had been to Italy to make Quo Vadis for MGM. And Elizabeth Taylor had just wrapped her most prestigious film to date, A Place in the Sun with Montgomery Clift. So, indeed, the careers of both Taylors were riding high. And it was while Elizabeth was in England filming this next movie that she met the man who would become her second husband, actor Michael Wilding. Here from 1952, an MGM biggie, Ivanhoe, directed by Richard Thorpe.